Good morning, students. Can you see the video? Any problem regarding the audio or video? Very good, very good. Okay. So last day I discussed on the reactions of metal with oxygen. Now can you tell me what is the compound form when metal reacts with oxygen or metal reacts with air? Metal reacts with air. Can you tell me? Metal oxide. Very good, very good, very good. Yes, metal reacts with air. Follow it. It may be air or oxygen. If there is air given, then don't be disturbed. It will be the main composition of air, that is oxygen, will react with metal. And also we have seen some layer of oxide which as a new compound, that is rust, sometime is the you are not audible, I think. দেখা যাচ্ছে না দাও এইখান থেকে আসলে একটা এন্ড নেই ওকে ওকে নাও ইউ ক্যান হিয়ার দেয়ার ওয়াজ দ্য ভিজিবিলিটি অফ দ্য বোর্ড ইজ লেস দ্যান ইটস ফুল এরিয়া So you cannot see the chapters. Now you can hear, all in. Now you can hear. So on the last day, now it can be audible to you. Okay. So metal oxide, and there was some compounds, that is iron oxide, which we know as rust, and some compound that is basic copper carbonate, which is also a compound which is formed in the reaction with copper in presence of air and water, right? Now follow your page number 48, page number 48. Now table 4.4, I have discussed it earlier, but once repeat of that, follow. Are you following this page number 48? Yes. Now the table 4.4, table 4.4, table 4.4. Now there the columns are serial number, name of the base, metal, name of the acid, and non-metal. So first one, that is name of the base. Sir, when copper monoxide is formed. When copper monoxide is formed, copper monoxide CuO, right? So the valency of copper here is +2. It is the general valency carbon monoxide. Okay. Carbon monoxide is formed when it is a neutral oxide. Sudarshan, what are you typing? So it is formed by incomplete combustion, incomplete combustion of coke, incomplete combustion of coke. It is formed when incomplete combustion of coke is takes place, then carbon monoxide is formed, because in saturation state or in the complete oxidation state, carbon produces CO2. Now it is an not complete combustion, it is the incomplete combustion of carbon. So follow the table 4.4. that means we have to use then not of it is a and not there is a adequate supply of oxygen is there the limited supply of oxygen is there according to their amount, then the carbon monoxide will form. Now table 4.4, calcium hydroxide, the metal is calcium here. This is an example given. Now what is the main composition of phosgene? PH3 is phosgene gas, poisonous gas. This is PH3 is phosgene. Okay, next, so move on the table, that is calcium hydroxide, right? So calcium hydroxide, it is the formula, that is calcium. You don't know about the formula because this will be discussed on the next class, but it is the formula of calcium hydroxide. Now the main metal atom present here is calcium. So you have to give some more examples on this. So first of all, we have take example of sodium hydroxide. So what is the metal here? What is the metal here? Yes, so here the metal is sodium. Then potassium hydroxide. What is the metal here? Is potassium. Any question? Jasmine, sir, would you please explain how to balance equation? Balancing is equation is discussed on the class 9, that is balancing comes through some steps. That is, here we have to balance the number of atoms. For example, do you know the how to represent an element or a compound? Those questions for Jasmine. Do you know how to represent the element or the compound? No, sir. So how can we define it? So first of all, we have to know the composition, that is the carbon monoxide, just for here calcium hydroxide, sorry, sodium hydroxide. So how to represent is symbolically. Now the sodium is represented as Na, N small a. No, it is not quite difficult. It is very simple. And hydroxide is represented as OH. This is the hydroxide. Now sodium hydroxide, that means combination of these two forms NaOH. Right? Now balancing comes after the formula of the compound or the element. Okay, as the classes will goes on, you will be able to do that work, that is the balancing and also how to represent the a chemical compound, not Na is small, not OH is small, O is capital, H also capital, right? When there is more than one word, that is Na, then A always will be small, C A always will be small. What is stoichiometry? Stoichiometry is the numerical coefficient. For example, suppose C plus O2, just one simple example. C plus O2 equal to CO2. Here we may assume that it is 1, it is not 0, it is 1, it is also 1. So here the stoichiometric coefficient of the reactants are C is to O is to CO2 is 1, 1, 1. For example, another one example we may take, that is Ca plus just Mg, Mg plus O2, that is MgO. Now just follow that the number of atoms is equal in both the sides or not. Magnesium 1, here also 1, here oxygen is 2, but here oxygen is 1. So we have to equate the number of oxygen atom on both the side. So first step, write down 2 here. Now as we write 2 here, it is representing 2 molecules of MgO. So the number of magnesium atoms, number of magnesium atom here is 2. Now there is 1. So we have to equate the number of magnesium atom. So now the equation is balanced. Then we can replace it by an equal sign. So magnesium 2Mg plus O2 equal to 2MgO. It is a balanced chemical equation. Balanced chemical equation. There are some methods also, that is approximation method and also the numeric method, that is algebraic method. We have to do it by in class 11. You have it in class 11. Here the oxidation and reduction reaction, why not MgO2? It is a very difficult problem for you. I may tell it, just hear about it, why Mg, not MgO2. Now magnesium and oxygen, how compounds is formed, this is according to their valency. We have to satisfy the charge of the every constituent. Now magnesium having plus 2 valency, because the it comes from the electronic configuration of magnesium, and oxygen with minus 2 valency. Now plus 2 charge is neutralized minus 2. So if we add MgO2 according to you, then what happens? The minus charge will be 4, minus 4, but it will be plus 2. So the charge is not neutralized here. So the compound is not possible by this formula. It is only possible by using cross multiplication of the valency that produces Mg2O2. Now deleting the subscript, we may write it MgO. How to balance the chemical equation of rust formation? The rust formation, as the I have written there Fe2O3XH2O, right? It is the formation of rust. Now the rust, that X, here X may vary, here X may vary. So it may be 2, 2 and half, 3, etc. So according to the number of water molecule, the balancing coefficient will be differ. But the general composition, that is Fe plus H2O, that is Fe2O3 and H2O. If it is 2, just assume it as it is 2. Now first of all, balance the oxygen atom. How many oxygen atom? 3 to 5. Here 5 molecules of water. I gave 10 number of atom, but here only 4. So iron, that is 2. 2. Now the oxygen atom and the hydrogen atom, we have to balance it. But how to balance it? Fe2O3, 2H2O, it cannot be balanced, right? Sir, does Sir, does balancing equation completely depends on valence cell? Yes, yes. Depends on valence cell for electrovalent compound. There is also electrovalent and covalent compound. For electrovalent compound, it depends on the valence cell. But for covalent compound, it is the sharing of electron. It is the sharing of electron. So for rust formation, we may write the general equation, that is Fe2O3 XH2O, because the number of water molecules is not known. Sir, but O2 is also there in rust formation, Fe2 plus H2O. The water and the oxygen, it is assumed that the oxygen is responsible. In presence of water, it forms the rust, Fe2O3 XH2O. Fe plus O2, it forms FeO, Fe2O3, etc. In presence of oxygen, it can produce this. Okay, I am moving to the text, far away from text we are discussing. But in presence of ammonia, in presence of oxygen only, it can produce FeO, mainly Fe2O3, because it satisfies the valency. Here the valency of iron is +3, here +2. So +3 state is most stable for the iron. Valence electron or shell and valency element, valency of element, valence electron, that is the electrons which on the valence shell. Question was ulto walta question was. Yes, Ishita, the valence shell and also the valency of element. The valency of element is the number of electrons it can release. It is the valency of electron, or what is the coordination, that is the it sharing the electrons is called its valency. But what is valence shell? It comes from the structure of atom, as it is assumed that it is the Rutherford concept that the shells are spherical in nature. So electrons which are on the outermost shell are called the valence electron, or this cell is called as valence cell. Sir, I am so no sir, I am trying to say that both oxygen and H2 are required. Yes, it is the essential condition, but when we represent the formation of rust, only to write iron plus H2O plus iron plus H2O, that is formation of rust. Now, just we are on the table, that is calcium hydroxide, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide. In four the cases, the elements which was iron, I am writing by symbol, magnesium, sodium, potassium. These are the elements symbol of elements. First one, iron, magnesium, sodium, potassium. So these produces the compound which is basic in nature. For this reason, we have told that the oxide is formed by metal is a metallic oxide or basic oxide. On the next column, the starting element or the compound is sulfuric acid. In the same way, if we add some more acid, that is hydrochloric acid, here it will be chlorine. Phosphoric acid, it will be phosphorus. Nitric acid, it is nitrogen, right? So these are all non-metals. So base, that is a metal produces base, and non-metals produces acid. Next, It is the new topic. We have to see, does losing of energy of a charged particle affects is mass, energy and mass? No, because we know E equal to mc square, that is Einstein equation, where energy and mass are energy can be mass can be converted to energy, but energy is the already energy E. No, it is not possible. Here a mechanical work have to be done on this to convert both of these, E equal to mc square, here m is mass, E is the energy. And charge, if you tell it as charge, that is charge does not also affect the mass. Nishar, okay. So move to the topic. So what happens when sulfur dioxide is dissolved in water? What happens when sulfur dioxide is dissolved in water? I have discussed on the last class, that is what happens when sulfur dioxide dissolves in water. Yes, yes, sulfuric acid. Okay, now you cannot differentiate between sulfuric acid or sulfurous acid, right? Now there is a difference in valency. What is this valency? Valency is the capacity of a compound or element with another element. It is the additive power or additive capacity of an element with other element. It is called as valency, and this comes from the electronic distribution, we may say, or there is a valency according to the group, which according to the periodic table. So if any element is situated in group 1 from the periodic table, those having the concepts of period, yes or no, it is correct, that is sulfurous acid. Sulfurous acid, the formula, there is a difference, and sulfuric acid. The difference is that H2SO3, not O4, but in sulfuric it is H2SO4. So you have to just take the concept that us, OUS and ic. OUS, here the oxidation state is lower oxidation state is used, or lower valency, lower oxidation states. As for example, here it is us acid and it is ic, that is higher oxidation state. Okay students, so move to the next topic, that is reactions with water. Now out of this reactions, there is so many metals in the periodic table or our world, that is up to 120 elements, more than 120 elements are discovered. Now there are few examples that is we have to know which directly reacts with water. For example, sodium, potassium, magnesium, calcium, they spontaneously reacts with water, but sometimes we require the higher energy, that is we have to use the steam, or we have to heat the metal, or we have to use boiling water, which will be discussed on the next class, that is reaction of water with metal with specific example. So us acid having lower oxidation state, ic acid having higher oxidation state. Sir, water is neutral in nature, but sir, why people are advised to drink lots of water when they suffer from stomach acidity? How water being neutral in nature neutralizes acidity? We should take antacid, because what water do? Water dilute the acid medium. Water dilutes the acid in the stomach. As it is largely secreted, so it is only the purpose of what taking water is only to dilute the water. Kharkwan copper displaced your Upasana, your questions from the higher class. You have also this on the next class, copper displaced zinc from its solution. Because copper is situated, if you follow the activity series, that is the activity series, you can find that zinc is far above the copper. So, according to the principle of activity series, which is situated above of any element, cannot can displace the lower element, but the lower element cannot displace the upper one. In this here, same examples, right? So, wait for the next class. I will meet you on the next class. What means the water rises pH scale? Key question.